Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dr. Chaturika Karunaratne from Molecular Diagnostic Laboratory, Katunayake. My research topic is profile of accidental burn injuries among children attending the burns treatment unit at Lady Ridgeway Hospital, Sri Lanka. Household accidental burns are devastating injuries that can occur in sudden, unexpected manner. Annually, there are about 200,000 burn-related deaths and approximately 100,000 children sustain fatal injuries related to fire accidents in the world. Children have a greater desire to explore their surroundings, which makes them more vulnerable to accidental burn injuries. They are poor in capacity to recognize and respond to the dangerous situations, and they have a very delicate skin compared to adults, which results in severe damaging effects from burns. Every child in the world matters. Therefore, as adults, it's our prime responsibility to make a safer environment for children, protecting them from preventable injuries. In Sri Lanka, only a few number of research have been carried out so far on pediatric accidental burn injuries. So I understood the importance of conducting a research on this crucial health problem. This research was a hospital-based descriptive cross-sectional study, which I conducted from August 2019 to December 2019 at Lady Ridgeway Hospital, Sri Lanka. I enrolled 170 caregiver child pairs for this study who attended the burns treatment unit during my period of research. I excluded the children with intentional burn injuries and the caregivers who had been taking care of the child for less than 3 months. An interviewer-administered questionnaire was used as the data collection tool, which contained the information regarding the socio-demographic factors of the caregiver-child pair, the type of burn injury the child sustained, and the safety measures practiced by the caregivers in relation to prevention of accidental burns. In addition, a data extraction form was filled by tracing the bedhead tickets of each patient to evaluate the severity of the burn injury. Majority of the caregivers in this study group were females. They were housewives belonging to the age group of 28 to 37 years. Most of the burn injuries were sustained by children less than 4 years, and almost all of them had no previous comorbidities. Nearly 65% of the children presented with scalds, and more than 80% of the children had second-degree burns. When evaluating on home safety practices, I observed that majority of the caregivers had electrical burns in children. Nearly 90% of the families had at least one uninsulated live wire at their houses. Greater proportion of the caregivers had not paid a specific attention in the direction of placing a hot pot handle on the stove. Opening of windows near the stove prior to gas cooker ignition was neglected by a significant proportion of participants. It was noted that there were few good safety measures practiced by the caregivers. Many were responsible in keeping all the electrical appliances away from children, and only a limited number of participants were using kerosene oil for household cooking activities. Even though some safety practices were satisfactory, there were identifiable malpractices among this study group, which needs further enlightenment. Education and awareness programs should be conducted to general public as well as targeted population, especially those who are taking care of children less than 4 years, and behavioral change communication programs on home safety practices should be conducted to prevent unfortunate burn injuries. Thank you.